Hi friends, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to share with you a lot of terrace garden ideas as well as DIY ideas. Hope you'll like them. So come along with me to Neha's beautiful home. As we enter her terrace garden, you can see greenery all around, beautiful flowers and many DIY ideas. A spray wall painting with the caption "Highway to Heaven and Hell." Some wattle plants and flowering cactus plants. See her creativity all over the terrace.
Terrace garden belongs to Neha.
Hi Rasmi. Hi guys.
Hi guys. So almost a year back Neha shifted into this house. Was it a year?
Just about 6-7 months back.
6-7 months back she shifted into this house and this terrace garden was practically empty. And then I asked Neha that what are you going to do? And she said dekhte jao. And ab aap dekhna Neha ne kya kiya hai and it's actually wonderful. So Neha, when did you start collecting plants?
As soon as we shifted, just about a month or so, then we started looking around for the easy maintenance plant.
Mm-hmm.
So we started with this hanging plants, creepers,
okay.
Then money plants.
Mm-hmm.
Then few of the plants I was already having it when we shifted here.
Okay. So you have some succulents also here.
But somehow succulents are not growing nicely here because it's very, it's a full day, it's like, you know, daylight is there and it's very hot.
Okay.
So otherwise rest of the plants are okay.
Yeah.
And I have in fact used lot of old items, whatever I had.
Okay, let's have a look. Guys, I'm going to take you near to some DIY items she has done.
So, can you guess what are those colorful boxes?
No, I can't guess, Neha.
So, they are actually a pencil stands. Your kids might be getting in the return gifts and all that.
Yeah,
so
yeah.
So, it was lying all over the places. So, it's a wooden one. So, of course, you know, it won't last long.
Okay, so guys, these are pencil stands which your kids might have used and she has put plants
so
in it.
So, what did I do is, like, you know, I just put the plastic inside.
Okay.
Can you see this? And then I tied with the rope so that, like, you know, even with the water, if it gets spoiled, at least it will be together.
Okay.
And then the less, like, you know, slow, low maintenance plant, I have kept it.
Okay. Very nice.
So these are the, this one, it's an old, you can make out, it's a old key stand.
Yeah.
So I use that one also for that.
For a plant?
Plant.
Yeah, can you show me near?
It's actually tied up, I think. But can you see like this?
Okay, can see some plants coming out. Yeah, yeah.
But of course, I have used the plastic.
Oh. That's a wonderful idea.
Now, see this. This is actually a cheese box. So, this is actually trial pieces. I have not done any coloring. I'll show you the another one which I have done it.
Okay.
So, what I have done is actually I just did the little cutting and the mud is like, you know, yahan tak hi hai. Then the plant is falling. So, you can use more of them like that.
That's a wonderful idea. I throw away my cheese boxes just like that.
And you know what is this red red stand
I have no idea.
This is actually a bunk bed.
Okay, bunk bed.
Yeah.
Okay.
I had hips bunk bed, metal bed. So it was.
So guys, this is a wonderful idea. If you want to make a vertical standing garden, you can actually use anything at your home. You don't do not have to buy it
or whatever
outside.
You have, you don't need to throw. You can reuse them. So I use this bunk bed.
Mm-hmm.
Part of the bunk bed.
That's a beautiful idea, Neha. And you guys can also try it at home. So now we go to the covered area, which she has made herself.
Normally we get a lot of sunlight here. It's very hot during the daytime. So what we thought is we need to give a shade to our plant. So yeah. Me and my husband, we decided to get some cloth, which is green, mm-hmm. and then the bamboo. So surprisingly, this also me and my husband only did it. We didn't get any labor or any person to help it for us. We only did it ourselves.
So you made this cover for the plants so that, you know, they can escape the heat of the day.
Yeah.
And I can see some wind chimes and hangings.
Yeah, whatever is at home, I just like, you know, whatever I don't want to keep it inside the house, I'll hang it outside.
Okay, so guys, you should never throw your...
So this is my girl's pom-pom.
Okay, a pom-pom hanging there.
Then this is, you can see that this is my son, what do you call it? Spinner.
Spinner, huh?
So I just use the spinner just like that to give the color, little bit of color.
Okay, this is also a very good idea. And I can see that she has used a part of the bunk bed again here to hang some items in the garden.
And I have fixed the light also. This looks very nice in the night.
Okay,
so I'll send you a photo for that.
So that's a beautiful hibiscus flower you have. It's a beautiful variety with red and orange and yellow color.
The more are coming here, but the plant is quite small comparing to the
flower.
Flower.
yeah.
Okay, you must see this. Ye hai Christmas plant.
Okay, this is a Christmas plant. Okay, very nice.
Many people must be seeing the red leaf.
Okay.
Basically, ye kya hota November se February tak.
Can you show me the red leaf?
It is coming.
Oh, so nice.
November se February tak isko color change hoke,
mm-hmm.
it will become red actually.
Okay, the whole plant
will become red.
Okay, that's a...
Then after February again, it will start turning back to green.
Okay.
So that is why during the Christmas time, you will see most of this plant everywhere, red only.
Okay, that's beautiful. It's, all the leaves will turn red.
And it will look very nice.
And then these are those makmali flowers.
Makmali flowers.
Okay.
This flowers actually... is very good flower to have it in your house because they are all season.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now the dry leaves will give fall down,
mm-hmm.
and then the another plant will come.
Okay,
so you continue aata hi rehta, so your garden will always have some
mm-hmm.
plant.
Mm-hmm.
You can use it for puja and all that. And the best part about this flower is they are little durable. It is not very delicate like other plants.
Okay,
so they will last quite long.
For a long time.
For a long time.
And such. Beautiful pink flowers here and red flowers. So you might be getting all your flowers from your garden itself, isn't it?
Sometimes I do it.
And now then your palms,
palms. I have got lemongrass also, which I use it for tea or during the cold. I just boil it and give the water to the kids.
It tastes very nice. If you like lemongrass, you can plant some at home and use
it. It is very easy maintenance. You don't need to maintain only.
Okay, I'll take some lemongrass from you.
Sure.
Now coming to some more palms here. Beautiful. And you can see some flowering plants. And let's go there. Okay, so I thought this was a natural flower. Actually, she's just done a DIY and kept some old flowers and put some flowers in it. And actually, they were looking like natural flowers.
See, these are my aloe veras. So I use them for my hair also. I remove them and I use for my hair. I use it for my face.
Okay.
So and aloe vera is very easy to maintain. So,
okay, you've got two aloe vera plants here.
Oh, I've got lots of aloe vera plants even at the kitchen side. So,
okay.
They are very useful for general use at home.
Okay. And now we come to the cactus.
So, this is actually cactus.
Okay, so beautiful.
Actually,
flower.
They look very beautiful. The plants are like, you know, the flowers are very beautiful.
I can see so many flowers on a cactus plant.
Red cactus is also. There's two different varieties. If you see, both are the cactus. This got the big petals and this has got the small petals.
Okay. It's got, very nice, so beautiful. And actually it's a cactus plant, you can see. Here also, these have got smaller leaves and the flowers are white in color. Yes. And so coming
another,
to...
This is another Christmas plant.
Okay.
Actually, Christmas plant, you break the stem. और उसको कहीं पे भी लगाने से वो अपने आप आ जाता है. You don't need roots or anything. You can break it.
Oh, that's a wonderful plant.
See, this is the same Christmas plant, more red leaves.
So beautiful. Guys, I must show this to you. Oh, wow. Is it a leaf or a flower, Nia?
It is a flower. This is called peace lily in the common name.
Okay.
And this plant also, this flower also lasts for quite long. It will be there for almost 10-15 days now.
Oh, so it's white in color, and as you can see, this is peace lily, and it's actually beautiful. You must plant it. So Neha, you've got a wonderful variety of cactus plants here.
Yeah, they are very colorful and very nice actually.
And
the money plant, can you see that? I have given
the money plant, and as you can see around, so many pots of cactus with flowers. Very nice. And oh my god, such beautiful flowers. So this is another sitting area
where basically my son uses it for his
play area.
See, you can see this is another part of bunk bed. So I have given the railing kind of thing, so it gives a little
so
height.
Okay, so it's a part of the bunk bed, guys.
Yeah.
And she has used it to make it as a railing so that her son does not fall off. That's a wonderful idea. And you can see his toys here. And he actually sits and plays in this area in the evening.
See, these are the stones.
Okay.
So she used the acrylic paint to make it little colorful. Basically what happened is tablecloths and all that, because it's windy here, it doesn't stay on the table. Mm-hmm. So I use this as a weight.
Okay, so some sort of paperweights to... You know, put the things in place. I mean, how many plants do you have in all?
Roughly around 120.
120, wow, that's great. And this is your tulsi, oh wow.
Yeah, that's my tulsi area.
Okay, very nice. Let me have a look.
This is basically for evening here.
I can see another candle stand sort of a thing.
See, this is basically again... cheese can box.
Okay, very nice.
You can use it as a candle stand, or otherwise I was thinking that I have made one hole. I'll just cover this hole and put some mitti and all that, and I can use it as a kitchen garden for weed grass and all that, because they don't need deep boxes.
Okay, and what's this?
This is actually a coconut shell.
Okay, so nice.
So I just scrubbed it and made it little smooth. Then I had some bits and pieces here and there, some kind of stands and all that. So I just used this to make it as a candle stand.
Okay.
So basically I used normal LED lights only. So you can put it LED light inside.
Okay. And this might be looking very nice at night.
Yeah, at night it looks very nice.
Okay, another candle stand and another coconut shell.
And this one, how I did is, I see normally... cheese box will have it its own print. So I just use the spray painting.
Okay, so you have used spray paint to paint this
tent? Yeah, spray paint. Yeah, just a black one. Okay, so then after that I just spread a little bit of glue water, mixture of glue and fevicol and water.
Okay.
I just applied on the box, and then whatever the design you want to put it, I just use the glitters and all that. So did
and
it
same
like
here. Yeah. Okay. And I can see a beautiful wall here, and... How did you do this?
This is done by my daughter.
Hi guys, we are back again. So like, I hope you enjoyed this tour of a beautiful terrace garden and you like the DIY ideas. And in case you want any DIY idea, I'll mention her email ID in the description box. You can contact her for that. And one more thing guys, she's also an interior designer. If you want any tips on interiors, you can very well contact her. She has a firm called Sujani Interiors.
That's Sujani Interiors. S-R-U-J-A-N-I.
And you can contact her and she will always be available to give you ideas.
So Rasmi, I hope you liked my garden and the tour.
Yeah, that was a wonderful tour of her garden. And guys, we'll be back with more tips on gardening and DIYs.
Thank you very much for watching us.
Don't forget to subscribe, like and share. are some pictures of the night lighting of Neha's terrace garden. Doesn't it look beautiful? Hope to see you again with some more videos.